Hello and welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to take a look at the November 2020 Tokyo Trip Premium subscription box. Before we begin, I need to let you know that this video is not endorsed by Tokyo Trip or by any other company. And I also need to let you know that I'm working on a comparison video between the Tokyo Trip subscription service and the Japan Crate subscription service. So I'm inviting you to press like and subscribe at my channel in order to watch this video and all the videos that will be coming after this. We can now move on with the unboxing of the snacks. So the first thing, as always, is the catalog. This is the volume 60 for November 2020. This time they've included three flyers. This is the normal thank you flyer, the hello, the welcoming flyer, hello to Tokyo Trip family, etc. And I don't know. Actually, I've never read any of these. So, this is the something about, yeah, they did some sort of change or mix up or something. Okay. Now you can see how this catalog is. And I'll put this here, and we're gonna move on with our first item, which is the Kalbi Katage Plum and Bonito flavor. I just saw it here. It's a classic item, and I think Bonito is some sort of fish, fish flakes or something. So these are probably going to be a little bit fishy. This is how it looks on the backside. And I'll put this here. And yeah, these are chips. I don't know if I mentioned it. These are chips, definitely. So, second item is sweet potato osatsu crackers. These are crackers with sweet potato flavor, and these are a premium item. This is how it looks on the backside. That's interesting. Sweet potato is really interesting. Now, let's take a look at this one, which is the onion taro. And it's a classic item. It's puff balls made from corn, I think, and yeah, from corn. And this one is onion flavored. That's nice. Now let's go with this one. I'm not sure which one is this. Oh yeah, I think it's the potato fries. So this is it's a salty snack, it's a classic item, and it's something with fries, with potatoes. Probably, yeah, they're trying to imitate the American French fries. So let's move on with to this item, which I'm not sure. Ah, it's the Yamato Turtle Crackers. So I hope that these are not turtle flavored. It's sweet and salty and crunchy, and no, it doesn't say if it has any turtle. I hope that it doesn't. I like turtles. Now, let's go to this one, which is the Aji Curry Chips. Another pack of chips. This is curry flavored. I like curry. Yeah, small packages, but it looks nice. Let's go to this one. It's the ramen shop snacks, crunchy ramen snacks, chicken with chicken flavor. So this is a ramen, crunchy fried ramen or something. They're really nice. I mean, I've had these, some like these before, and they were really nice, really tasty. So I'll put this here. Let's go with this one, the red one. It's a don don yaki kimchi flavor. I think that kimchi is some sort of cabbage, fermented cabbage or something from Korea. Yep, this is a blend of Korean and Japanese treat. Yeah, it's a cracker. It says here that it's a cracker that tastes like kimchi. Never had kimchi. I've only watched it on, I've only seen it on TV, and I don't know how it tastes. I hope that it tastes nice. Let's go with the blue, which is a small constellation choco cookies. So this is a cookie. This guy looks like Cupid. Anyway, or like an ancient Greek. I don't know. Now, let's go with Umaibo cheese. This is a classic Umaibo cheese flavor. You've seen Umaibo before. You know that, you know how these things look. We're gonna take a better look at the taste test. Now. Okay. Let's go for this item, which I think that it's some sort of Swiss roll. Uncle Pierre's roll cake. Another classic item so far, apart from the Yamato turtle crackers and the sweet potato osatsu crackers, everything else is classic, and this included. And it's a roll cake. I've never had one of these before. I've never had a Japanese roll cake before. I've heard lots of good things. Now, which one is this? Mochi taro. Well, for mochi, it's a bit dry, but it's a taro. I think I've had taro before. And it's something fried, if I remember correctly. Anyway, this is the mochi taro. Let's go with this, which is squished as well. No, it's a colon. Yeah, classic item as well. Colon. Okay, I think it has something. Yeah, it has something to do with this, thing. So, it's a premium item. It's either coconut sable cookies or sweet potato colon. I got the colon. I hope they're happy with this. I'm not. I'm joking. Let's go with this item, which is a caramel taro. So it's like the other one that we saw earlier, but with caramel. This is how it looks on the backside. And now, let's go with this one. It's a pokey. It's a classic item. It's a pokey tasty. It says here that it's milk chocolate with pretzel base, made. So it's a classic item. So I believe that this is the classic pokey or something. Although maybe it has some sort of caramel or something. It's creamy, it says here. Okay, we'll see in the taste test. So this is how it looks like. Looks nice. I like pokey. And let's go with another coffee. If you've watched my Japan Crate video, you've seen that it also included Daido X Demon Slayer sweet coffee. So we get another one here. with a cute anime girl this time. The other time was like a crazy guy or something. Last item is the... I think that it's the last. Yeah. Last item is the Kit Kat Japanese cheesecake. So another Kit Kat. This time with Japanese cheesecake flavor. I've never had Japanese cheesecake. I don't know. I like the normal version. I'm gonna tell you my opinion on the Japanese one. Yep. Okay. So it's a paper packaging. So that's cool. Now I'm gonna arrange everything and let's see. Sorry about the camera. I hope that you can see everything. Okay. This one here. And this one here. So these were all the items included in the Tokyo Treat November subscription box, the premium edition. It seems like a normal box, like an okay box. I'd love to have this, to have had this earlier, but things aren't going very well with Tokyo Treat these days. They seem to delay everything, at least to this part of the world. Now, if you've enjoyed my unboxing, please press like and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next video. Thank you for watching. Bye!